Booker from the DNA Fund and Jeremy Gardner from Awesome Ventures. Scott, before we talk about the investment approach, tell me about DNA Fund. Who is DNA Fund?
Well, DNA Fund was really created several years ago with my business partner, Brock Pierce, and I. We've been in the space, early stage investors together, mostly technology. Somehow we fell into Bitcoin in 2012, began mining Bitcoin, learning as much as we could about the technology. And once we launched our mining operation and we started receiving Bitcoins, we did our best to come up with a way to take those Bitcoins and try to invest them into different projects. Little by little, we learned that there was opportunities, and of course, the ICO market and the crowd sale market began, and it kind of took off from there.
Let me take you to your 2017 investment thesis. Let's go back to 2017. How did you invest in 2017?
Well, in 2017, it was really the year of the ERC-20 launches. So what we would see is a lot of early stage startup companies. I call them the two kids in a garage with a white paper and a vision. And recognizing only a couple years before, Ethereum was a couple kids in a garage with a white paper. Remembering how that affected the world, we were all very interested in finding, if you will, the next Ethereum. What's the next amazing project out there? So a lot of these, I would call them, they would start out as small teams with great ideas. And I think it expanded really, really quickly from there.
So small teams of geeks with white papers. Jeremy, let's talk about your 2017 investment thesis.
What Scott means by that is that he invested in everything. He was undiscerning.
Okay, let's talk about your investment thesis for 2017.
My thesis was a bit more skeptical. As someone that had actually gone and done two ICOs, I created the first utility token with Augur, the first security token at Blockchain Capital. I knew what an undertaking ICOs were. And I was looking at these teams of geeks in basements, I was like, you guys are never going to pull this off. And so I actually missed out on some of the early ICO trend because I just saw these teams and I didn't think they would be able to execute. And guess what? They didn't. But people still made a lot of money on those investments because they went up a ton initially.
Any regrets of investments that you didn't take in 2017 that you probably should have?
And this is entirely on me. I'm super close with the EOS team, and I was just so skeptical of delegated proof of stake for a long time. And so I missed out on investing in Block One, the company, and then I didn't invest in the early token sale either. And so, I got in early enough, but that was definitely my biggest mistake when all my closest colleagues were deeply involved in the project.
So Scott, I'm coming back to you. How is 2018 different?
So I'm going to agree that I wish I got more involved with EOS. Thankfully, there was a YouTuber that had recommended EOS, Kubera, I believe is his name. And so I did buy a good amount of EOS. I would say it's one of my top 7 or 8 coins. I definitely own a lot more in Coinbase coins. But a lot of this stuff, it's all hindsight. And if you've been following me in particular, I'm very skeptical about ICOs, and I haven't really made any big moves. Been sticking with the top 20, top 10 really when it comes to cryptocurrencies. But like I said, if you're able to buy these dips and you were dollar cost averaging in February, March, April, you're still going to get a really healthy rate of return. And it looks like the market is just continuing to pump. So like I said, don't get FOMO. Obviously, it's nice to have 200-300% rate of return. But for me, I'm happy with 20%, 30% and not losing my shirt. So I'll stay conservative, but let me know what you guys think. Obviously, there's going to be plenty of opportunities to invest in ICOs this year and the upcoming years. And obviously, with experience and better knowledge and understanding of the technology, it's going to become easier and easier to make better decisions that not necessarily be the best. But let me know what you guys think, and I will talk to you guys soon.